trying to get the brake drum off, and I've got it moving, I think. There's two threaded holes there, and you can use the bolts out here of the right size. So I'm just tightening it till it stops, sort of thing, and then going to the other side. And it seems to be on the move, hopefully. I did heat it a couple of times, put in WD-40, let it sit for a couple of hours. Yeah, it's moving now. My next challenge is how to hold it in the lathe. Should be okay, it's a gap bed lathe, I can take the gap out if I need to, which is, means you've got to take a chuck off. She's coming. It keeps squirting some WD in it, between the heat in it, it seemed to have the heat in it and the pressure. Probably an 8 longer bolt, so that's on there. Unless it just lets go. Well, if everything else in this tractor's fucked me, so why shouldn't this be, why should this be any different? You know what I mean? There's a big lip here, and if I can machine that off, it'll fit on the brake shoes better. I'm a bit tight at the moment. The thing is, if I've got the drum off, I can offer it up to the brake shoes. See, get to the point we can actually slide it on. Half an inch of bolt left. Yes, and I did read the manual to see how these came off. You know the saying, if all else fails, read the... there's another word in there, manual. Doesn't always tell you the truth, though. Yeah, I'm trying to sort tomorrow. I'll just give it another bit of a heat, just to help it. It's come a bit. Get it cleaned better. I haven't mentioned Barry today, or Steve. Steve is the Path of Discovery on YouTube, I think he is. He's messing about with his slightly older tractor, I think, David Brown. And Barry Holden, he's in his garage. I haven't figured out how he got the tractor in the garage yet. There's not a lot of room. So he's doing everything spot on. Unlike me. I just want it to work. There's a will, there's a way. Yeah, if you want to see how to do everything just to the T, I would have a look at Barry's stuff. Special valve chest and that. It's something else. Right. And a squirt. Stuff disappearing. It's up flush with that now, so it's coming. I don't know how long the splines are. But I'm just about out of bolt. That could be my next problem. Ah, it's very tight now. leave that to rest for a bit. Anyway, that's apparently how you take the drum out. I've never been inside these either yet, but I'll do that once it's back to the tractor. Check there's oil on them. This needs to come off. You can buy this bit. You can buy this bit new and it's not that expensive. 18 quid or something like that. David Brown Parks have got them. They've got an eBay shop, but if you phone them direct, it's a wee bit cheaper because they don't have to pay commission to eBay. That's like 10% or something, isn't it? Let's see if I can get these off before I put back in the tractor. So, what I do is I heat it, WD-40, and screw it in as tight as going, and you leave it for a wee while. And hopefully the upward pressure will move it a bit more. Well, I could be doing my rest. I'm going to pack it in shortly anyway. See, we'll get a turn on it. Leave that overnight. See what happens. Right. We'll hear the birds twittering away in the background. So, if you've been following the channel, I was using the existing bolts, which are half inch 13 UNC. Down in there, but we're running out of bolt and we've still got to get from there to there. So I went and purchased, I've lost my balance a couple of times today. I went and purchased some longer bolts, but there's not enough thread on them, so we're just going to wait to recut them. My imperial set and the red one over is metric, and I've got some new tools. This here is a pipe threading machine, I suppose you would call it. You've got different dies. These ones that are in, they'll do half inch and three quarter BSP pipe, steel pipe, or MLI pipe we used to call it. It's that long since I used one, I had to think about how to use it. And there's a couple of more sets of dies there for it as well. Also, I purchased some safety glasses, and that is a 5/8 11 Tarpon die. UNC. I don't remember the reason I wanted that, but there's a reason. Got some O-rings. These are hopefully fit the hydraulic pipe. And some new inserts. I think some of them not quite the size I wanted, but what's new? I've got a few threads. They're not right to the way I want them yet. So, usual setup if you've seen me doing this before. I've got a zero that I always go back to. Yeah, and we've got 130 on here. Let's go back a bit. 120 should clear us. Do another run. The problem is I don't have a nut to try on. It's still bigger than it. Yeah. I can leave it. Do another run on it and see what happens.
other one.
We just finish it off in the 12:45, 12:23. What I think I'll do is finish it off with the die in the vise now that there's no such stuff to cut. Anyway, I brought it over here a minute ago. It's here. The longest thread I can cut on it at the moment because of the nut on the far end. I had the option to turn these round the other way. It wouldn't hold it so well. Right, we'll go over and see. That first bolt I made, it's too small. I've got it too small. The second one's okay. So I've just been gentle with it. So I can use it to hold on to. Oh, this one belongs in one of these holes. What daft person wanted to take the fucking brake drum out? Another option is. I'm just going to cut a bit off the end so it ends up in a different place. Might solve the problem. So that thread's actually bigger than that thread. We'll give it a bit of setting. Right, one of these first, I think. Well, that's the original thread. That's going into the bigger thread, so that might work. Reverse. Oh. quite warm. Where the fun's going to begin. Just going to slip it. Okay, we'll just have to use it as an anchor point again. I think the thread's just going in that one as well. Now we're really in trouble. Yep. Threads are stripped now, so I think they're not looking too bright. So let's see if I've got a dart we can run down it. Could be the actual bolts that are a problem, I think, maybe. think in the way I start screwing, I don't think it is. Bottom. See what happens. Something. This one. Nah. That must be a bad one, isn't it? Let's see if we can get any movement on this one. Nope. Not sure what I'm doing. The switch off there for me. I've put a slight snag. I hope to remedy the two holes for putting the bolts in and bringing them out. The threads are now stripped because of the forces, so I'm going to wait to see if I can tap them. Slightly bigger. Right, so that's the drill. Drilling them out to 14 mil and then tapping them 16. Let's drill them on a blade. See what happens. Problem. We need to put the brakes on. Should we gonna do that? Let's see if I can get my leg in here. Get on here. far down it is. It's not that much bigger a hole. Oh yeah, quite nice to go here. Hey, 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 hey. Get back there. I think that's just going through, judging by the... Splashed out in some 16mm tube taps. I can't get a shot of in my pallet to blast my shit. It seems to be a hole that comes up quite often. So, I'll give it a whirl. We've managed to make a bit of progress. It's come up about 10 mil maybe, so it's quite slow, so I'll put you on a time lapse till we get the thing out. And keep your fingers crossed we do get it. I managed to get both holes tapped to M16 and pinched the two bits of rod that's on there off the back of the welder I use as handles. So that worked out. Well, that was a fight and a half. That's only taken me 3 days. And as you can see, you need fairly long bolts. I'll cut the ends off of them because they're mushroomed. Look at the muck in there. Clean all that out. That thing is cute. Boy, that's a tad challenging, shall we say. That seems to be the way to get them out, is use the bolts that you've got until they strip the threads and then put them up to M16. And what I was doing is I tighten one side till it goes tight and then tighten the other side till it goes tight and work back and forth, and that seemed to bring it up. Plant a field of tatties in here. Or potatoes for those in Northumberland. They'll know who I mean. Still got to get the thing back on as well, but we can use a hammer to do that, I think. And get to clean up the surface now where the seals sit. don't know if I'll tackle the other side or not. I'm not sure. Some of the bolt holes come right through in here. Once it started moving, I mean, originally it moved up about half an inch, then it ground to a halt. But once we got it moving this time, it just seemed to come. So if you do need to check your brake drums out for any particular reason, you're going to have fun. That's moving pretty well. Right, go on. So put that in. Bring it up. Here we go. I would have started wearing gloves again. It's taken an awful long time to get my hands clean. I get them at the local chemist, but they don't always help them. And these are better than the last lot I got. I looked up the oil for in here, and it's gear oil 140, which I think is the thickest you can get. I did look in there, but it's pretty bad in there. Oh yeah, it's needing an oil change bad. I think that we could see. Some WD-40. Clean it. Okay, once we get this back together, the next job's putting the taking out the piston out of the hydraulics at the other side and maybe the three-way valve and see what we can do there to get it to work better. I bought a seal kit for the hydraulic pump, and I'm just going to give it a go and see if it's any better with the new seal kit in it. And get a bit of tidy up inside. looking better. I'll get the, hopefully get the wire brush and the angle grinder onto that shaft and clean it up before the brakes go back. This is back to front compared to normal brakes. Normally you're taking them the outside, but here you're in the inside. I need to clean all these surfaces as well. I'm assuming there'll be some kind of gasket on here. Mind you, there's no oil in here, so I probably don't need a gasket. Kind of drain plug or something in there. Not sure. Recess. I don't want to do this. I'm just going to leave those keys in. Ready to put the drum back. Get that cleaned up pretty well. Just giving it a preliminary, I can't say that word, preliminary, is it clean? Get the worst of it out. Actually get working brakes. Well, one side anyway. In here. That's a drain plug. And it's choked like everything else. Yes it is. Well, I never knew that was there. That's been choked for a long time as well. That'll be to let any water out. It gets in there. I learn something new every day. Every day I say it, I shouldn't have bought that David Brown. It was in the price bracket I was looking at, so. Cheap. Just put the cover back on with the bolts that were there, so bits of the gasket will be missing. Just leaking oil somewhere. Maybe the seals behind there. Once it's the right way up, it should be okay. So, then would they know that there was a drain hole there in the bottom of the carton for the brakes? Right, it's not too bad. What better than it was anyway. Right, I think our next mission's getting those two M16s out of the drum there. Put them on the grinder through and wind them back. Oh, this will get that cleaned up as well. Still a lot of wee nooks and crannies. I'm going to get some comment asking what that is, likely. Don't tell the wife I clean like this, or she won't let me do the house next. Sometimes do anyway, when I'm up for it. Polish before that goes back. I think that'll be the original paintwork that's in here. Tractor's been resprayed at some point. And then it was parked in a corner beside the sea and left it rust for a couple of years. I decided to sell it. Right, I'll get that with the wire brush. More clean, I'll get this bit off as well, something. Maybe that one will come off, but I'm not sure it goes to. big enough for something that's never going to be seen again. Hopefully. There's a seal in there. It's one of the reasons I didn't want to heat it too much. The bearings and the seals, until I got it started. So, I'm definitely going to clean that. You can feel, it is smooth like, but there's a couple of lips. Wouldn't be surprised if it's slightly tapered. Right, we're doing now. Oh yeah, we're away. Let's see if we can machine this. Okay, I'll get the brake drum sorted out and I'll bring you back once I've figured out how to set it up in the lathe to just machine the drum out there. I'll give this a clean as well. I've given it a measure and it's only needing a 1/16 of an inch. But we'll see how it goes. Oh, it's indicating now. Ready to rumble. Right in, get rid of the root, the rib. Cast iron's always messy when you're machining it. Thank you.
morning.
Right, oh, that's it. We can try it on the tractor. One of my jaws is going to need some attention. Probably as much of jaws as the screw. It's showing about a millimeter. Yeah. It's big enough. On these particular shoes. I think we're still needing a bit of it. That's measuring 21 and that's measuring 18. 3 mil. I wonder if it's a tag you put on last night. Pads must be thicker than the originals. Right, lovely. I'm going to call it a day, I think. Aye. Right, I'll get back to it tomorrow.